Hi there. So we're going to talk about getting knocked off your life path or your lifeline. Say things, you know, you've got it going, and then you get knocked off of that. How do you get back on? We're going to approach this from the teachings of reality transurfing by Vadim Zeland. Okay? And specifically, we're going to look at the phenomena of a particular kind of entity called an egregor, also called a pendulum in reality transurfing. And it's these pendulums, or egregors, that can knock you off a positive lifeline. Okay? So, the overview of how it works is that you can be going along doing well in life, and you're on track, and you're going in the direction you want to go. And something in life, well, you'll encounter some, you know, some tragedy, some person, group, job, some phenomena, relationship, accident, illness, but you'll encounter something that will cause you to think differently. And the thinking differently, this thinking is what triggers and attracts the entity, egregor, pendulum. Now, let me lay a little background here, what this means and how it works, because we want to be able to spot the entity and detach from it. And when that entity gets into our space, it affects our thinking, our focus, our feelings, and our attention, and our behaviors. And how do we shake that? Okay, so if you can shake it and stop thinking negative things, stop focusing on that negative stuff, stop feeling the trauma or the emotional pain of it, then you can now refocus, and now you're thinking about positive things, and you're feeling more positive, and this will put you back on a positive lifeline or put you back on track in your life, generally speaking. So, an egregor is a group consciousness created entity thought form. Okay, so in this demonstration, we are going to use the targeted individual. That's going to be our focus. Okay, so we're going to be talking about the targeted individual as a demonstration, because a lot of people are targeted in all this. And so when we become a targeted individual, you think about you do your research, you find out what a targeted individual is, and you go, yeah, that's me. all these entities, when you have a collective thinking about them, they're all thinking about the same information, and they're all having similar emotions regarding being a targeted individual. Like, it's not good, it's bad, it's freaky, it's whatever it is. But that's the emotional, energetic part of it. And it's a structure in the mind. So whether you're feeling like you're a targeted individual or not, you know what that is. And your informational, energetic structure in the mind is that entity. Okay, now as the collective, I don't know if you're going to get this or not. This is kind of deep and kind of weird, and you actually should read the book Reality Transurfing to get a better understanding of this. But basically, when many different people are thinking of the same thing, it's a collective thought form, and it can manifest into an entity, and it'll take on a life of its own. So the idea of being a targeted individual can become an entity egregor. And how it will get into your space and stick to you is by virtue of you thinking about it. So you're thinking the same information that the collective is thinking. And you have the emotional stuff, that's the energy. And so that informational, energetic phenomena becomes the structure in your mind, and it manifests as an entity in your own mind, in your own space, and it can affect you Does that make sense? I don't know. So anyway, here's a technique that you can use, and it will help you detach from an entity, egregor. And the idea is that, generally speaking, you want to spot what it is that you're thinking and feeling that is a frequency match to the entity, and you detach from the entity. Now, it'll stop being in your mind space, but, you know, other people are still thinking and feeling it, and so it's going to be an entity egregor that's floating around affecting other individuals, but it won't be affecting you anymore, okay? And this is just one technique and one approach to dealing with entities and getting yourself back on a positive lifeline or a positive life path, okay? So this little technique, I can teach you and work with you on this if you want to do it with me in private, but I'm just going to go through it real fast here. So, what's the situation, condition, or emotional issue being addressed? Well, we are going with targeted individual. Let me, excuse me here. Okay. Oh, excuse me. Here we go. Describe and label the collective thought form. Okay. So, the targeted individual. This is an individual that is being targeted by some third party, agency, entity, group, being, demon, secret space program, you know. Could be just anything at all. Incubus, succubus, astral weirdos and reptilians. It could be just anything. Extraterrestrial ETs. But they've got you targeted for one reason or other. So, and they're harassing. So, next step. What kind of entity are you serving? And we say serving because you're thinking about it. As long as you're thinking about being that, you're feeding it. And the way you're feeding it is simply by having your attention on it, on the idea, the informational phenomena, targeted individual. Now, I'm thinking about a targeted individual right now, whether I feel like I'm one or not. But I'm feeding it with my attention, and I'm feeding it with any emotional phenomena I have, whether it's positive or negative. It's still, what it's doing is feeding the informational energetic structure in my own mind. So I am creating or feeding the phenomena in my own mind. Now, is it really bothersome for me personally? And am I being traumatized and I'll be infected in serious ways like some people are? No. But I am feeding it. And so are people that identify as being a targeted individual with issues. Now, I am not saying that these things aren't really there bugging you. Not at all. They are really there, and they are really harassing you, doing terrible things in your world. Okay. I have a lot of clients, and this stuff is going on all the time. This, what we're doing here, is one way, one strategy you can start learning to detach from contributing to the creation of this group-created entity called an egregor, also known as a pendulum in the reality transurfing teachings. And all these steps and stuff are derived from the first four chapters of reality transurfing. What kind of entity? I'm just going to assume, okay, I'm targeted by something. Something out is around here, you know, watching what I'm doing and would love to bring me down and all that stuff. So we can use it in that way on myself so I can demonstrate this as a real phenomenon. Okay, so what kind of entity am I serving? Well, is it a personality collective? Yeah. See, it's like there are many different people in the world that collectively think of the targeted individual, and it's a personality type. It's also an individual, but as a reference and a name, we call it a personality collective thought form, because various personalities that have this issue are thinking of it collectively, thus thought form. Okay, but you can also, a family can be an egregor pendulum. A country can be a pendulum. A political party, a religion, a society, brotherhood, fraternity, club, team, all these things can be egregors. All you got to do is think about them and have feelings about them, like Microsoft. There's a collective, thousands and thousands and thousands of people think of Microsoft. So that's the information. And thousands and thousands, if not millions, have emotions about Microsoft. And collectively, these emotions and thoughts create the collective consciousness of what is Microsoft. Among other things, it's a collective entity / egregor / pendulum. All right. So we're looking at specifically the kind we're dealing with today is the personality collective. All right. Next up. In common with the collective thought form, what do you think and believe? The targeted individual thing? Well, I think, yeah, probably targeted a little bit. And that's collectively, that's what other people think too. They think, yeah, I'm targeted. I believe I'm targeted. What do I believe? I believe personally, and you would, you know, in the down here in the columns here, you write what you believe. I believe that these entities they totally want my louche. I believe other things, so I just keep writing everything I believe and what I think I have in common or with the collective thought form. Okay, so next question. We go over here. Now we want to look at what hooks you into this collective thought form. What is it? These will be the things that you agree regarding the phenomena, and you adhere to those agreements. So the idea is to spot these hooks, these agreements, the way you behave. We'll talk about this a little bit more in a minute. We're going to make a list. Specifically, we've got the various kinds of hooks. So you start looking at how you are hooked into, or it is hooked into you. Okay. So, in common with the collective thought form, what do I feel? Okay, the way you look at this and come at it is like, being a targeted individual, how do I feel? Well, it pisses me off. Motherfuckers leave me alone. Okay. Now, do other people think the same thing? Other people are thinking, motherfucker, leave me the fuck alone. That's the energy, emotional energy, that I have in common with other people that think the same thing about this particular kind of entity, egregor, pendulum. Okay, so collectively, we are thinking it together. We are creating the phenomena of this egregor. Yeah. So we look at that. Because what I'm thinking about it is a frequency match and an emotional, energetic match to what many other people are thinking about the phenomena being a targeted individual. The entity itself is a targeted individual. That's what it's being. Okay. So when I think about it, have feelings about it, I'm a frequency match to the group, mass consciousness, thought form, targeted individual. Not the entity that is targeting individuals. No. That's a different thing. This is the targeted freaking individual. It's an entity. Yeah. When we identify with it, we become it. And then we start thinking like it. As a matter of fact, we are contributing to the thinking of it. What are the rules and beliefs and behavior patterns of a targeted individual? It's the rules and beliefs and agreements and behavior patterns that you have relative to being a targeted individual. So you're contributing to the collective unconscious creation of this thought form. And this is the sort of thing we want to look at. Spot what you're thinking and feeling, what you have in common with the idea of being one with the entity. And as you spot it, you start detaching from it. The truth of it, you spot the truth of it, it's like it disengages. So all these different hooks, we're looking at one at a time, boom, 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 boom. And what it does, at the end of this, you get to that place where, oh, you are no longer identifying with or being one with the targeted individual idea. The informational energetic structure in your own mind, no. You're no longer thinking it. You're no longer feeling those feelings about it. You're no longer adhering to the belief systems of a targeted individual and all of this. Do you see how this gets kind of deep? But, okay? All right. And the idea is once you detach from it, you're going to feel good and feel better. And now that you're in a feel good, feel better place, you're no longer knocked off your life path or lifeline. You're in a good place. And now this allows you to think about and have good feelings about your future and about your life. Now, because there's more than one entity, egregor, in one's life, there might be a little bit of work to do here. And this is just one kind of entity work, but that's what I want to share with you today. So I'm going to share a little bit more of this particular technique. And you can find out a lot more about it in Reality Transurfing, the book by Vadim Zeland. But he doesn't break this technique down in those first four chapters. I just saw how it worked, and I go, oh, okay, this is what we have to do. And so I put this together to help myself and anybody else that wanted to give it a go. Okay? So, okay, there's another kind of hook. Let's see, what is it? Is there an emotional payoff you get by identifying with this pendulum egregor? Or what is the emotional feeling that you get, that you like, by being part of this group, collective, entity, pendulum thing? And you go, what would I like about being a targeted individual? If I'm identified with being a targeted individual, I don't see an emotional payoff. Like, ooh, this feels good. So you can either ignore the question or you can look deeper to see if you can find something. So if I look deeper, I'm going, targeted individual. Well, there it is. I can relate to people who are targeted individuals. See how relatable I am? I'm a real guy. I can relate. Yeah, I know what you're talking about, targeted individual motherfuckers. They're after all of us. And there's a sense of being right. You know, different people will do a lot of study and teaching, study and research on the phenomena of entities in general. And there's all kinds. Astral entities, alien regressive ET entities, thought forms of our own creation, incubus, succubus, demons, all that shit. And these thought forms where somebody creates a thought form thing that's out to get you, and then it sends it off to your space. Like spell casting and djinns and genies and all kinds of creepy ghosts and dead people, dead fucking relatives, people with a grudge. They dropped fucking dead and they never got over it. Now they're haunting your fucking house. Entities of all kinds, right? So as you do this kind of research, you can you go, yeah, I know what you're talking about. And it's right. We are being fucking targeted. The motherfuckers won't leave us fucking alone. So now I can get righteously fucking pissed about entities and being targeted by the motherfuckers. And so that would be the emotional payoff. I had to dig for it, look for it. But yeah. Being right. Being righteously freaking angry. Yeah. That's my payoff. Yeah. It's a hook. I'm digging it. So I'm laughing and chuckling it up here. And this is releasing me and detaching me from the phenomena. It, you know, life is what it is. You know, things are how they are. I don't have to, you know. Just because you walk through a field full of fucking fleas. You walk through a fucking dog pound or something. I don't know what the hell. And there's a lot of fleas there. And you get some fleas. By the time you get to the other side of the fucking fence, geez, that's a lot of fleas. Yeah, they're fleas. You walk through a field full of fleas, you're going to get fleas. Doesn't mean you're a targeted individual. It's not like every flea there is like, I'm after this guy. And you don't have to identify as the targeted individual. You know, you still understand the phenomenon. So it's kind of like that. So I got my laugh and a chuckle. So I'm going to wrap it there. But this is how you start detaching from these things. Okay. And you detach by getting the emotional release and realization, blah, blah, blah. Okay. But there's a lot more here. I'm not going to read them off all, but here's another hook, how it controls and manipulates us by us agreeing to it. And you can, you will behaving a certain way. Some people won't, they try to do a certain kind of release work or meditative work, and it'll trigger aches and pains and serious trauma, emotional stuff, because the thing is pushing back. So that's a control and manipulation phenomenon. So you know, if you got to go deeper than where I just went to clear it, you look at these things. And then there's common goals or intentions. What could I possibly have in common with a targeted individual entity phenomena? Well, the targeted individual wants to be free. Me too. If there was a being, an entity out there in mind space, being a targeted, not being the entity that is targeting you, that's a different kind of entity. We're not going there right now. But the targeted individual is, oh, poor targeted individual, as an informational energetic construct in the mind of humanity. Egregor, pendulum. That thing is out there. What's it? It wants to be free. It's got a kind of a life of its own. It's as if it's sentient. But it's a thought form, group, collective. And it wants to be free. It doesn't want to be targeted. I don't want to be targeted. I want to be free of that shit. So common goal or intention to be free, for example. Okay. So another thing we can look at, I don't have to do this anymore. I kind of got my release, right? But we can look at what's the downside of being an adherent. And being, when you adhere to the belief systems of being the thing. And right now we're addressing targeted individual. But this works on many different kinds of entity, egregor, pendulums. This little technique, and it's an entity release technique, you could say, but specifically built around the egregor phenomenon. Okay, what is turning you into or making you be? This is a beingness or state of being. So anyway, that's another deeper look if you need to look at it. Then you can ask, how much energy is it consuming? How much loosh? It's really, we say these entities suck our loosh. They feed off of us. But you know what? We are feeding them. We choose, it's fucked up, but we choose to focus on being that thing that we're being, and we're one, we're melted with, or one with the egregor. We have become it. It has become us. We've blended and melded with it. And so now we are feeling the feelings of being that thing. And that's us emoting. That's us feeding the entity. We are keeping it alive with our own feelings, emotions about it, and our focus on it. We're thinking about it. So how do you not think about that shit? Yeah. Well, you do a technique like this. There are other techniques, but this is one. Okay. A lot of times built into these belief systems and rules of behavior while you're being the targeted individual, for example, if you were to rebel against it, it can start destroying your life. It doesn't want you to stop thinking about it or having feelings. It doesn't matter if you feel good about it or feel really bad about it, if you love it or you hate it, you're afraid of it. Doesn't matter how you feel, as long as you have feelings about it and put your attention on it. You're feeding it. You're keeping it alive and existing in your mind space. Even when you detach from it and stop thinking about it and feeling about it, and it's not, you're not identifying with it, you've detached from it, you're like, whatever, what's going on? Hey, other people will still be feeding it and all that, but you don't have to be involved. You can just look at and understand the phenomena. Okay, so anyway, there's that step, and a lot of times, not always, not every one of these entity egregors will give you a sense of superiority because you adhere to that. So that may not apply to this particular one. Then there's just more steps and more things you can look at. Others can act aggressively sometimes, depending on the kind of entity or egregor it is. They can act aggressively if you try to leave. Stop, you know, like somebody, if we're to say, just an example. You're just one more fucked up human being. And you go, no, I'm not. And you don't identify with the egregor, a fucked up human being, right? No, I'm not. Well, other fucked up human beings will piss off. Yes, you are, you fucked up human being. I'm not a fucked up human being. You're a fucked up human being. Anyway, others can act aggressively toward you when you try to break free of a egregor pendulum. Okay, yeah. But that's another subject. There's a whole lot more to the subject. I highly recommend the book, Reality Transurfing by Vadim Zeland. And you get a free copy, PDF. There'll be a link down here. Check that out. It's just one link, click, bang. Download PDF, free, no, you don't have to, anything. And if you'd like to get a training session with me, I'll teach you how to do this, and I'll walk you through it, and we'll do it together. You can find that over at richwest.net too. Okay. So this has been my little video explaining if you get knocked off your lifeline or your positive life path, one of the things that can do it is you've encountered one of these kinds of entities called an egregor, also known as a pendulum. It's got mass, it's got meaning, it's got informational, emotional stuff in it, and it's got a frequency, a rhythm, or a beat. Frequency. And when you become a frequency match, you think the same way the entity is thinking, the frequency of it, and the emotional phenomena of it, your frequency match, boom, it becomes you. You become it. You create it in your own mind and identify with it. Really quick, and you don't mean to. Shit happens. But now that it's got its hooks into you, these steps and stages can help you get the hooks out, spot them, detach from them, and be free of it. So that's it, folks. Thanks for watching. Okay, I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.